Hello, I am Dr. Vibhash Kumar Baid. Today I will discuss about the anatomy of the cuboidal fossa. Cuboidal fossa is a triangular hollow which is situated just anterior to the elbow joint. If I am talking about in my body, so this is our elbow joint, and just anterior to the elbow joint, or other word, upper part or anterior part of this forearm, we have a hollow triangular fossa. This fossa is called cuboidal fossa.
When we see in the specimen of cuboidal fossa, you can see here, this muscle is called brachioradialis muscle, which is present on the lateral side of forearm. And this oblique place muscle is called pronoteres muscle. And this triangular space is called cuboidal fossa. When you see the boundaries of cuboidal fossa, so the lateral boundary of cuboidal fossa is formed by the medial border of this brachioradialis muscle. This muscle is brachioradialis muscle. And the medial border of this cuboidal fossa is formed by the lateral border of this pronoteres muscle. Then base. The base is directed upward and it represented via imaginary line joining the front of the epicondyles of humerus. This imaginary line which join these two epicondyles of humerus, this is called base. And apex, this apex is directed downward and it formed by the area where the brachioradialis muscle crosses the pronoteres muscle. Here you can see this brachioradialis muscle which crosses over this pronoteres. So this structure is apex. This imaginary line which join two epicondyle, this is called base. This one is lateral boundary of cuboidal fossa and this one is medial border of the cuboidal fossa. Then the roof, in this specimen the roof is removed, but the roof is basically formed by the skin. Superficial fascia which contains the medial cuboidal vein joining the cephalic and basalic vein. The lateral cutaneous nerve of the forearm lie along with the cephalic vein and the medial cutaneous nerve of the forearm along with the basalic vein. After the superficial fascia, we have a deep fascia and bicipital epineurosis. Here you can see this is bicipital epineurosis which is arise from the tendon of the bicep. When we split the boundaries of a cuboidal fossa, we can able to see the contents of cuboidal fossa from the medial to lateral. First, here we can see the median nerve. Median nerve is the most medial content of cuboidal fossa. This median nerve is a branch of the medial cord of brachial plexus. After the median nerve, you can see here the termination of the brachial artery. And this brachial artery, which is a continuation of the axillary artery, and this brachial artery further terminate into two another branch. From lateral side, you can see here this is radial artery, and from the medially here we can see this one is a ulnar artery. After this termination of the brachial artery, you can found here this is a tendon of the bicep brachii muscle. This one is tendon of the bicep brachii muscle, and most laterally, here you can found this is a superficial branch of the radial nerve. Radial nerve, which is a branch of the posterior cord of brachial plexus. When we split the contents of the cuboidal fossa, we can able to see the floor of the cuboidal fossa. You can see here this muscle is called brachialis muscle, and just laterally here we can see here this muscle is called supinator, which is surrounding the upper border of the radius. These two muscles form the floor of the cuboidal fossa. Clinically, this cuboidal fossa is a very important because of the median cuboidal vein is often the vein of the choice for intravenous injection. And the blood pressure is universally recorded via the auscultating the brachial artery in front of the elbow. Then the anatomy of the cuboidal fossa is useful while the dealing of the fracture around the elbow, like the supracondylar fracture of the humerus.
So this is all about the anatomy of cuboidal fossa. Hope you understood. Thank you very much.